Today, we are going to start our discussion on control statements allowed in the C programming language. So, there are various control statements in C. The agenda for today is to discuss about a particular class of control statements to perform what is called selection. We can have a quick look at various types of control statements allowed in the C programming language. Basically, they are classified into selection, iteration, and jump. Under each category, there are various statements permitted in the C language. For example, under the selection type of control statement, there are if statement, if else statement, and switch statement. And the agenda today is to discuss about selection except switch statement, which we will do in the next class. So, this is the agenda for today. With this, now we can move on to the topic for this lecture, which is about control statement. And before we see the first control statement, that is if, let us see which are the different types of control flow during the execution of a program. In how many different ways the program control can flow through the program is what we are going to see. We are going to look at it in a general way. This is the first type of control flow. That means it is straight line. It starts with the first statement, then executes the second statement, then the third one, and it progresses like this. So, this is what is called straight line execution of the program, where statements are executed in the given order, meaning after executing the ith statement, the next statement to be executed is always I plus 1 the statement. So, that is straight line execution. Another way of control flow is this, where the control is initially straight line coming to a decision point from where you have to take a decision. So, there will be a condition to be evaluated. If the condition is true, the control flows to the right branch of the program, or it flows to the left branch. So, this is what is called selection, where the control flows through one of the two possible paths. Two possible paths are there. One of them can be selected based on the value and condition given in this point. If the condition evaluates to true, you proceed like this. Otherwise, you proceed like this. The example will make it clear. Please don't get worried about how exactly this is written. That we can see later. Third one is iteration, which means a statement block. Maybe this is the statement block that I am talking about. Is repeatedly executed till the condition at this point evaluates to false. And in the C programming language, false is represented by the numeric value 0. There is no Boolean data type. Numeric value will be used to represent true and false. False means 0. True means non-zero. So, until a condition becomes false, this part of the program needs to be executed again and again. So, this is called a looping. or iteration. And the last type is, suppose your program control is at this point of the program. From there, maybe you can go back to a previous point, or from this point you can move forward. And this type of control flow is what is called jump. Control can jump to an arbitrary position in a function. So you can either move forward or backward. So these are the various types of control flows possible in a program. That is straight line execution without changing the control flow. You are going line by line in the order in which the statements appear in the program. Or selection is possible. That means after coming to a point, depending on a condition, you decide whether you have to move to the right or to the left. Or iteration, where you can repeatedly perform something, or you can jump also. Later we can see concrete examples in each case and statement. Now we are proceeding to the first control statement that we are going to learn from the C programming language, which is conditional execution within the selection type of control flow. As the name indicates, the execution of a statement is going to be conditional, meaning that statement will be executed only when a condition evaluates to true. We can try to understand first with an example and later formalize the statement. Here is an example. Let us not worry about what it is. We can try to look at the execution of this program. Now suppose the program gets executed, and this is the program control coming to this part of the program. When it is coming to that, the value of the unsigned variable V is assumed to be 10. So in the memory, this variable is having the value 10. And now the first statement executed is this. So what is the value of this variable? 10, which is greater than 0. Yes, this condition is evaluating to true. So naturally, this statement can be executed. This is called a conditional execution. Only when this condition is true, this statement can be executed. In some languages, it is called guarded execution. Guarded execution. A guard is there, like a watchdog. Only when some condition is met, the control is allowed to go inside. In this case, it is allowed, so the control jumps inside the loop, the if, and next statement executed is this. So the value of the variable is decremented by 1. Previously it was 10, now it gets to 9. And after the statements within the if is executed, here it is only one statement. In general, there could be any number of statements included within curly braces. Now after this, naturally the control comes to the statement just after the if statement. If statement is this whole part is if statement. Just after that you have this printf, and if you execute it, the value is getting printed, which is not. This should be 9. Now this statement is executed only when the condition evaluates to true. So this is the take home, conditional execution. Now you can look at the other case of this code. Suppose the program executes and the program control comes to this with the value of this variable as 0. The first statement executed is this. The condition is checked, but it is 0 is not greater than 0. So the condition evaluates to false. So you cannot execute this. So the control progresses directly to the statement after the if statement. Not that the if statement includes this condition check and the statement after it. So if you execute that, the value is getting printed over here. So from this simple example, I think the use case is very clear. Now we can try to look at another example use for this conditional execution. Here is a function which is absolute value of a decimal integer you want to find. You know that an integer can be negative or positive. So what you are doing is you are checking whether the given value is negative or not. If it is negative, you are multiplying it with minus 1. So you will get a positive value. So it is guaranteed that you will always get a positive value. And here you have to perform this only when the given number is negative. So it is a very simple illustrative example for guarded or conditional execution. Now look at the formal syntax. So this is the syntax. If is a keyword, if followed by a condition in parentheses. So less than, greater than means this has to be replaced with any expression whose value evaluates to true, which is 1, or false, 0. In C programming language, there is no Boolean data type. So false is represented by 0 and true is represented by 1. You can try to understand, so when you program, you see, you just try to replace this with 1 and see what is happening. And following that, you can have a statement. What is a statement? That we have to see later formally, but in general, it could be one statement or a number of statements separated with semicolon provided within curly braces. Now you don't have to worry about it. Later we can see. So this is the syntax of conditional execution using if statement in C. Now, this is a simple statement, that is just one statement or a compound statement. Later we will see what are these. Now you can look at selective execution. It's not just conditional, but it is full selective execution. Out of the two different statements, you can select one. Look at example first. Here is a small part of a program in C. Here again, we will look at an example execution. So don't worry about the code now. Suppose the execution starts with the value of the decimal variable V1 as 20 and V2 as 10. So these are the values. And what is it doing? First, it's checking a condition. It's an if statement. Now, the value here is 20 greater than 10. So the condition evaluates to true. So naturally, the control flows into the if statement. So the dmax, the decimal maximum, is getting the value of V1, which is 20. So dmax is getting 20, is what this is doing. And not that, this is a statement where if the program control goes in because the condition is true, then the else part is skipped. It is not executed. So immediately after that, the control flows to the statement just after the if else statement. So this is what is called the if else statement. Either the if part or the else part is executed depending on the value of this condition. Okay, if it comes to that, when you print, what you will get? You will get 20 as the outcome. So maximum is 20. Now just look at the opposite case where suppose the execution starts where the value of V1 is 10, V2 is 20. Yeah. When you come to this statement, when you evaluate this, 10 is not greater than 20, so the condition is false. Condition false means you have to go to the else part. If the condition is true, then come inside the if, otherwise go and execute the statement inside else. So depending on the condition, either this statement is executed or this statement is executed. So after that, definitely you will float the statement. So maximum is getting value of V2, which is 20. In this case as well, you are printing the value of Dmax, which is now 20. With this simple example, I think the use case is very clear. So this is selection. Depending on the condition, you select either this statement or this statement for execution. Now look at the syntax. Here is the syntax. If is the keyword followed by a condition which evaluates to either true or false, and one of the statements, and each statement can be a simple statement or compound, what they are later we have to see. So statement 1 or statement 2 will be selected for execution depending on this condition. And the previous example was to find the largest of two numbers. Now we are coming to the last statement that we are going to learn in this lecture, which is what is called if else if ladder. If else if ladder. Just look at what it is. Look at an example program, a part of the program. Let us not worry about what it is now. Just try to see an execution. So there are actually n plus 1 statements, statement 1, statement 2, etc., n plus 1. And each one of these statements are guarded or provided with a condition. And why it is called selective execution is, if you look at the previous case, one of the two statements is selected for execution from if else. But in this case, one of the n plus 1 statements is selected for execution. Okay? And expression I, like expression 1, expression 2, etc. Expression I is an expression which evaluates to true or false. Not that in C language, true means 1, false means 0. And the conditions, that is expression 1, expression 2, etc., are checked from expression 1. First, this condition is evaluated. And until the first condition evaluates to true is found, all the conditions from the first conditions are evaluated. And the moment you get into a condition which is true, you will execute the corresponding statement, or that particular statement will be selected for execution. And if none of these conditions from 1 to n are evaluated to true, then it goes to the else part. It's just an extension of the if else statement. Look at an example execution. Suppose the control comes to this point and it has to execute the condition first of the if statement, and now assume that the condition is evaluating to false. Because it is false, you cannot select statement 1 for execution. So naturally, you will go and execute the next condition, evaluate the next condition. And suppose, in this case, it evaluates to true. The moment a condition evaluates to true, the corresponding statement is selected for execution. So you go inside, execute that, and after that you can go out of the if else if ladder. The moment you select one for execution, after that, the control goes to the statement just after the if-else-if-else-if ladder. So what is if-else-if-else-if ladder? The whole statement. So I think from this example usage, it is clear to you. So it selects one of the n plus 1 statements for execution. Whatever be the values for variables of your program, only one of these statements will be executed. And which one will be executed? Suppose all the conditions are true, then statement 1 will be executed. Why? Because the first moment you will get it as true, you will select this and go out. That's it. I hope it's very clear. And if none of these conditions are true, it comes to the else part and executes the else statement over here. So that is again selective execution. And with this, we are finishing this lecture, and I'm giving you exercise problems which you can practice in the lab. Already we have discussed the program to find the largest of two numbers. Now the exercise next is to find the largest of three decimal numbers. And you assume that the input numbers are representable by the data type int. You know that the moment you represent it in a computer, it is bounded. So that is why this assumption is there. And now you can try if else if and try to implement a program. Just look at our algorithm and convert it into a program using the if else if statement. One more exercise problem. Write a program to read the total marks obtained by a student in an examination out of 600 marks and display the result status as defined below. Just read a number which is the total marks obtained by a student out of 600. And the result status is defined like this in the closed interval of percentage from 80 to 100. The status is first class with distinction, and from 60 to 80 is open, that is not without including 80, just before 80. Now first class in this interval it is passed, and if it is less than 40, I think this should be open. Okay. And sorry for this typing mistake, this should be 0 and this should be 40, 0 to 40, and 40 is the open interval. I will correct it in this slide. Then you have to declare that the student failed. So maybe these are simple illustrative examples for you to practice what is selection and conditional execution. So today we have seen conditional statements in C. In particular, we have seen two different selections. One is by using if statement, where you can either execute a statement or not depending on the condition in the if. Then we have seen if else, which is selection. From two statements you can select one of the two depending on the condition. Then we have seen if else if ladder, where you can select one of the n plus 1 statements based on the values of the variables and the conditions given into the if else if ladder. Thank you.